of ex-prime ministers has been provided with this. And under the Constitution, we are all equal before the law, unless you have a separate category. And the separate category is that of the Prime Minister. But all others, they are being not heads of government, they cannot be given a privilege which others are not given. That is equality before law. Now, the argument being given popularly is that two members of the family were assassinated. If you look at the facts of the assassination, that has nothing to do with the lack of security. In the case of Mrs. Indira Gandhi, the IB had presented a report saying that two of your security guards are infected and they should be transferred out. It's on record, it's there in the various commissions which have gone into this, and it was not approved by Mrs. Gandhi herself and also members of the family. And those very two guards assassinated her in her own house, not when she was on tour or when she was addressing a meeting. In the case of Rajiv Gandhi, Mr. Tulsi quoted Justice Verma's, and I should know it better because I was the one who moved the resolution here in the House at that time. And I just got hold of the report submitted, which was laid on the table of the House. And paragraph 7 of the recommendation says, the Commission has also observed that the Congress Party workers and organizers at the venue of the meeting did not extend the required cooperation to the police and created impediments in making proper security arrangements for Sri Rajiv Gandhi, particularly in ensuring strict access control in his proximity. About the responsibility of the Congress Party and organizers of VIP programs, the government has accepted the recommendation, that is Narasimha Rao's, of the Commission, that some guidelines and code of discipline should be framed for political parties. I challenge Mr. Tulsi to say where it says in that report of Justice Verma that because SPG was withdrawn and therefore Rajiv Gandhi was assassinated. There is no such reference at all. And that's a standing challenge to my good friend, Mr. Tulsi. Now, today, what is the threat perception? It must be very serious, otherwise Z Plus would not be given. But none of those threat perceptions which went earlier, when Mr. Narasimha Rao amended the act to give this extra special coverage of SPG to Mrs. Gandhi, Mrs. Sonia Gandhi and the family. One is that the LTT threat, Gujarat government was toppled on the grounds that the DMK, which killed Rajiv Gandhi, was a member of the government and therefore the Congress is withdrawing support to the Gujarat government. Mr. Gujral's son is here, he may not remember. It is absolutely on record. It's on record.
It will examine. Please.
Please. It's record. It is true.
Please. Please.
Now,
it will examine. It will be examined.
Now,
it will be examined.
She said that.
Honorable members, this will be examined, I told you. Yes, this will be examined. Please.
Now they are friends with the DMK.
Please.
LTT also. The Supreme Court said that this crime was so gruesome and so much against the nation that they should be given capital punishment. Mrs. Sonia Gandhi wrote a letter to the President, which I have a copy of, where she advocated that this would be wrong and in the name of interest of justice, their punishment should be reduced to life imprisonment. Later on, the daughter of Mrs. Sonia Gandhi went to the jail to meet Nalini. Wait a minute. She went to the jail, and the jail manual said only relatives can come and meet convicted prisoners. That was broken. She broke the prison rule. And so there is no threat from LTT. What else is the threat? Islamic forces cannot be threat to because they are very secular. We are the ones who have to suffer for it. So I would like to say, to conclude, first of all, it's a constitutional principle of equality before the law. It applies to them. There cannot be a separate constitution for them. The constitution applies to all of us. Second, we want them to be all alive because I would like to see them to go to jail on corruption charges.
Sri B.K. Hari Prasad.
The blame game over the alleged security breach continues in Parliament.